So I know there's a lot of people who understand exactly how the Free Night Planetary Freecoaster works. But for those who don't, this is a cassette Freecoaster that you do not have to disengage or re-engage. I'll show you exactly what I mean here. So you can hear it cassetting. Immediately, we can Freecoast with it. We can even pedal forward while we're Freecoasting. And then when we turn it around and we cassette again, we have pedal pressure. Crazy. But also, BSD just came out with their new Revolution hub, and it uses the same planetary gearing system as the Free Night. So as you can see, cassette, Freecoaster, cassette, Freecoaster, cassette, Freecoaster. So we're gonna get this on the bike right now and give you guys some first impressions of this hub. All right, here we go. Got the wheel on. I have not spun it yet. First impressions. It sounds different. Does it coaster? Yup. Yep. So it appears that it works the same, and now let's actually try to ride on it and get first impressions there. Because my first impressions whenever I got the Free Night and I didn't break it in enough, were that I wasn't sure how I felt about it because it was engaging on me and all of these things. But in the BSD, there's some lubrication inside the hub that could mean that there's no break-in period, but we have to try it to find out. So let's do that right now. And what better way to start this out than something extremely demanding on the hub, like 180 over the spine, to, immediately turn it around and pedal at an abubica and then land the abubica and fakie. Felt extremely smooth. So in giving my first impressions on this hub, I kind of wanted to do a science experiment. So before I switched out the hub, I rode the Free Night and I tried to make it engage. I tried some abubicas, I tried some of the stuff that made it engage when I first got it, but I simply could not make it do it. I even did an abubica and started pedaling forward as soon as I landed. And as you're seeing now, it did not engage. So there's not much I can do there. But there's something I can do in regards to crank flips, because a lot of people ask about crank flips with this new BSD hub. And the Free Night here was phenomenal for crank flips. I was doing accidental triple crank flips at the trails, not even knowing it until I edited the video. And so I did a little line where I did some crank flips with the Free Night. And now I'm gonna try and do some crank flips with the Revolution. I'm not gonna go straight in for the same line because I don't know how it's gonna work yet, but we're gonna see how a double crank flip might work on this hub new out of the box.
Oh, no.
Okay, so the verdict's in on crank flips. Doubles aren't happening yet, singles are fine. A little slow though. So now let's experiment with that abubica landing and immediately pedaling that I was talking about earlier, because I just couldn't get the Free Night to engage. And at this point, you guys have seen the verdict. No, what am I trying to say?
Is that that new Freecoaster?
It is. Okay. I knew you were gonna wanna check it out.
I'm gonna take a couple pedals.
Take a couple pedals, man.
The bike is so different.
It feels smooth.
That's kind of what I was getting ready to say.
It feels really smooth.
Yeah, like.
Oh, really nice.
Like when I just did that part that you saw, it felt smoother than on the Free Night. I don't know how to describe it though. So I'm pedaling around here, back pedaling and forward pedaling, engaging the hub. And it definitely feels like the engagement might be a little quicker than on my OG free night. I mean, this is totally just subjective here, but I'm pedaling around, back pedaling and forward pedaling. And yes, it is instant. It also feels like it might be there a tiny bit quicker. Could just be me though. And earlier I did do a sound test of the free night so you guys could just hear the difference. So let's cut to that right now and then we'll cut right back to the sound test on the Revolution. Now that Cody's here, I have a favor to ask. Can you just try and tire tap on this hub?
With pedal pressure?
It's the new one. Just feel it out. Okay. Just feel it out. Because I can't tire tap with pedal pressure.
Oh, you had it or no?
More of a manual.
More of a manual?
I think I'm going to do like a lane type of thing.
That was definitely pedal pressure. Yeah, that's the new BSD Revolution. Does it feel any different than mine based on memory?
I think this one has less slack, but I think it's because it's new.
Well, I said the same thing.
Nope.
First and last attempt at that.
Oh my God.
So tire tap, yes. 270 tap, no.
My heart is racing.
Thank you. Yo.
First try.
Holy
crap. Oh my God. Well, I think it's safe to say that I like my upgrade with this hub.
So you're calling it an upgrade, huh?
Is if you can do like full cabs or turn a fakie around with pedal pressure, which not sure how you do that with a coaster anyway. I'm gonna try because we did try with the free night.
Can I try any way I want?
Whatever.
Because I'm going to pedal back just a little bit, but I'm going to floor it forward.
Oh, yeah, don't do that.
Did you just do that with pedal pressure?
Ow.
Oh, no.
He's hurting.
But that was kind of pedal pressure.
It was kind of?
Whenever I was rolling forwards, I gave it a crank and a ground. But
well, as soon as you move forward again, it's going to be. That makes sense. Yeah, 100%.
So I think the pedal pressure engages a lot faster if the wheel's going that way.
I'm inserting this from later on because I just realized I forgot to do it, but I did film a test with the free night where I kept pedal pressure as I was rolling up the quarter to keep it engaged, and I wanted to see how similar this was to it. We'll see. Exactly the same. I'm not sure how good you'll be able to see it, but if you keep pedal pressure on it when you're rolling up something to go fakie, it's going to stay engaged naturally. But all it takes to disengage it is like a twitch of your foot, as you saw. Well, the day is winding down here, and I feel that I've done enough to be able to confidently give my first impressions on the BSD Revolution Hub. So upon first riding this thing, I felt like I noticed a smoothness to it. It felt like it might have been a little more smooth. I have no idea how or why that could have been, or if it was just placebo effect or something. Also, the fact that it felt like there was a little bit less of a gap in the engagement, like it was a little closer to instant. Once again, I don't know if this was just me or if this was because it was brand new and I haven't ridden a brand new Free Night in over a year, but I'm just saying what I noticed in my first impressions. I also noticed that I did not engage this hub, or the hub didn't engage while I was trying to do fakie tricks nearly as much as the brand new Free Night did. This hub feels like the Free Night did after I broke it in, which leads me to believe that there may not be a break-in period on the BSD Revolution. You can see I'm going back and forth here very easily. And this is not knocking the Free Night whatsoever. That hub just needed to be broken in when it was new, and it is going to be using the new materials of the clutch system that the BSD is. So hopefully there won't be a break-in period anymore moving forward. That being said, I did do a lot of fakie tricks with this thing tonight, and it was really no different than riding my current Free Night in its broken-in state after riding it for a year. Had no complaints whatsoever. It was a smooth transition. The only thing that I feel like I could not do that I could do with the Free Night is double crank flips, as you saw. And I think that might have something to do with the hub being brand new, and I think it's going to get better over time. At least I hope. And with that, I hope that I answered some of your questions. If you have more, leave them in the comments down below, and I will make subsequent videos on this hub just like I did for the Free Night. I gotta give another thank you to Grant at BSD and Tal at Free Night for giving me the opportunity to make these videos about the Free Night and now the BSD. And if you guys enjoy this video or have any other questions that you might not have had answered yet, leave them in the comments and then check out the game-changing Freecoaster playlist right here to see all of my videos about the Free Night, because most of the things about the Free Night overlap to the BSD. That being said, thank you guys for being here. And if you're new here or you didn't yet, consider hitting the subscribe button down below so that we can see you tomorrow for another video. Thank you for watching, and goodbye.